Hello everyone, this is going to be the first of a couple tutorials where I just create some enemies. Two things before we get started. First, these are building off of the prior tutorials in the Let's Make an Enemy series, and I'm going to be using code from those tutorials without explaining it. Second, we're still missing a lot of pieces to truly make good, complete enemies. Things like health, animations, and so on. So these are really more like skeletons of enemies. But these skeletons, these concepts are important, and I hope that seeing them explored in different ways will give you ideas for creating your own unique enemies instead of being tied to the exact enemies that I create. So with that, let's create the first enemy. This first enemy is going to chase the player, or really anything. It was inspired by the Metroids in the original Metroid, but I often use it for items that are attracted to the player. Think of the money from Hollow Knight. I'm going to create the enemy and call it Object Chaser, and I'm actually going to start in the step event. We want this enemy to chase the player. At a basic level then, that means that the enemy needs to know where the player is. And while there are many ways to do it, I'm going to do this by subtracting the enemy's X position from the player's X position and then getting the sign of this number. The sign function returns -1 for negative numbers, 0 for 0, and +1 for positive numbers. So if the enemy's X is 5 and the player's X is 0, 0 minus 5 will be -5. We'll know that the enemy needs to move to the left. If the player's X is 10, 10 minus 5 will be 5, we'll know that the enemy needs to move to the right. And we'll do this for both the X and the Y position. We need to reference our player, so I will do an instance exist check. And then we will want to use this value on our speed, which will be H speed and V speed. But here we go, we have that code I talked about, sine of object player.x minus X times the acceleration force. This will act a little bit like speed, except it will be a value that is added to speed every time. So instead of saying equals, should say plus equals. Once we have this, we can simply call our moving collide script. Now, of course, we need to initialize these variables. We have h speed equals 0, v speed equals 0, and accel force equals 0.1, which is a number that I just found works well in testing. Now, of course, we need to assign our enemy a sprite. I have one here, which is just a tiny square, and put our enemy in the room. Now we can run it. You can see that we have our little enemies. They're chasing the player around, trying to get to the player. And of course, these could be enemies. These could also be items. They could be power-ups or something, things that the player would collect when they ran into the player, or anything along those lines. There's actually one variation I would like to add here. And that is, what if we wanted to be able to limit the enemy's speed? Well, we can simply add a check here. If limit speed is true, then we can simply clamp our H speed to max speed negative and max speed positive, and do the same for V speed. Then, of course, we need to add these variables to our create event. But now let's run it again. Now you can see that our enemies cannot move faster than the max speed, but they still move just like before. And of course, if we want to disable that, we can simply change this to false. And here we go, our enemies no longer have their speed capped. I would strongly recommend playing around with some of these variables and trying out a few different ways of doing this. But now let's move on to the next enemy. For our next enemy, we're going to use the idea of attracting, of moving the enemy closer to the player that we used with our chaser enemy and our crusher enemy. We're going to create a new crusher enemy that will seek the player and try to crush them. I'm going to duplicate our lurking crusher and rename it object moving crusher. Just like before, I'm going to start with the step event. I'm going to rename this to seeking and do a quick find for all the other places we used waiting and change them to seeking. Now, all we really need to do to update this state is add in the code that moves the crusher. And we're going to pull this code directly from our chaser object. So we can come over here, we can copy our movement code and then paste it in. But I don't want this enemy to move along the vertical direction. So I'm only going to have the enemy move along the horizontal direction by deleting the two lines that move the enemy vertically. Also, when we switch to the falling state, we're going to need our H speed to be zero, since now we're actually adding to it. So I can set H speed to zero here. And that's really it for our step event. We don't need to do anything to our alarm one event. We do need to add our new variables to our create event. We can go pull those from the create event of our chaser object. We do want to limit the speed. And of course, we want our initial state to be seeking. Now we can put this enemy in the room. Let's turn off our chaser objects and run it. As you can see, the chaser object now attempts to go to our player and then crush them while still using all of the prior code. Note that the collision line is in effect, so it won't try to crush us here. So hopefully this gives you a good idea of a couple ways to modify the enemies that we've created so far. And in the next few videos, we'll mix and match these concepts even more. So if you want a challenge, try mixing the enemy that jumps towards the player with the crusher enemy so that it jumps high into the air and when directly above the player goes straight down. Or what would you need to add to our little square NPC to keep it from walking off of a ledge? These videos will be coming out over the next few weeks.